Okay, so let's get started with day two. So here day two, I'm just starting with the saha, sa, tat. It's the same examples as yesterday. So this, I think we are all familiar with these things. So now, important thing to understand in this saha, sa, tat, tat is that in Sanskrit, let's go back to English and see how we use he, she, that in English. So we use he and she for all living beings, like he is Ram, he is Bhai, he is God, and similarly she is a girl, and she is lady, she is Mala, she is Sita, and she is so like that. We use he and she for all the living beings, and non-living beings we mostly use that, like that is book, and that is pen, and that is flower, and that is door, and that is temple. So we will not use he and she for non-living beings, like that is book is the right one, but we will not say he is book or she is book. But in Sanskrit, there is an exception. So any non-living beings also will be addressed with saha and sa. So they also categorized as masculine and feminine in Sanskrit. So I could show you few examples, like vrikshaha. Vrikshaha means tree, and margaha. Margaha means the road or the street or path. Devalayaha means temple. So let's take example of vrikshaha. So vrikshaha, we will not say like tat vriksham. We will say saha vrikshaha, because the word vrikshaha is a masculine word. So we must use saha, like saha vrikshaha. Similarly, saha margaha, that is road. So we will say kind of he is road, saha margaha, and saha devalaya. Okay, the vrikshaha, margaha, devalayaha. So like that, there are other words like vidyalayaha, karyalayaha, dantaha, padaha. So most of such words, they are all masculine words. And similarly for feminine, I have few words like vatika. Vatika means the garden, and kupi means bottle. Nadi means river. So vatika, so it is a feminine word. So we will not say it is garden or that is garden. We will be saying she is garden. So sa vatika, and sa kupi, sa nadi. So similarly, we have other words like sa dvichakrika, two wheeler, and sa vedika, the stage. Sa patashala, the school. So like that, the words, certain words are categorized as feminine in Sanskrit. And similarly, tat is also used to address few living beings like mitram. Mitram means friend. We will say tat mitram. We will not say saha mitram or sa mitram. We will say tat mitram. So basically, it is friend. Okay, so here the important thing to notice here is all the words in Sanskrit are categorized into one of these three buckets: masculine, feminine, or neuter. So when we learn any new words, we have to learn which gender it belongs to. So accordingly, we can use the pronouns, and not only that, the gender plays a very important role in Sanskrit grammar. So that is why, as a beginner, you can learn all the new words with gender information. Okay, so let's get started with them from next one. So we already know to frame the sentence, simple sentence like saha ramaha, he is Rama, saha ganeshaha, he is Ganesh. So how do we make questions out of these words, like saha ramaha, so he is Rama? So what could be the question for this statement, he is Rama? So question could be, who is Rama, or who is he? So either you can put question at the place of Rama or at the place of E. The same applies here as well. Saha Ramaha. The question word for Saha will be Kaha. So you can actually ask Kaha Ramaha or Saha Kaha. So Saha Ramaha. So he is Rama. Kaha Ramaha. Who is Rama? Saha Kaha. Who is he? It applies for everything. Saha Yuvakaha. Kaha Yuvakaha. Saha Kaha. And similarly for feminine, it will be Ka. Sa Sita. Ka Sita. Who is she? Who is Sita? And Sa Ka. Who is she? And similarly, Sa Devi. Ka Devi. Who is Devi? Or which Devi? Both mean, it means both. And Sa Ka. Who is she? And Sa Vatika. She is garden. I mean, it is garden. And you can say Ka Vatika. Which garden? Or similarly, Sa Ka. Who is she? And for that, we already know the word Kim. So we already used in the first sentence like Bhavataha Nama Kim. It means what? So Tat Pushpam, Kim Pushpam, what flower is that? And Tat Palam, Kim Palam, what fruit is that? Tat Pustakam, that is book. Kim Pustakam, what book is that? And similarly, the other way, Tat Pushpam, we'll have two questions like Kim Pushpam or Tat Kim, what is that? You can just point out any object, you can ask Tat Kim, what is that? Okay, so now let's have a small exercise. You people can take, frame any sentences with Saha, Sa and Tat and try to make questions for those statements. Like I can say Saha Ramaha or Saha Devalayaha, or I can make a questions like Kaha Devalayaha or Saha Kaha. So these are the two possible questions. So can anyone make sentence and make frame questions for those sentences? Okay, so here a small thing to observe. I didn't say that point. So whenever you get a new word, just observe the ending letter of ending of that word. If the word ends with aha, it is a masculine word. If the word ends with dirgha letter, it is a feminine. If the word ends with im, that is neuter. So for example, Ramaha, Ganeshaha, Yuvakaha, Bhaktaha, Devaha. So all these words ends with aha, aha. So similarly, Vrikshaha, Margaha, Devalayaha. So all these words ends with aha. So these are all considered as masculine. And similarly, the words which end with long letters like Sita, Mala, Mahila, Devi, and Vatika, Kupi, Nadi. So all these long letters, long oval ending letters, the words, they belong to feminine. And similarly, there are words which end with Im, Mitram, Dwaram, Vastram, Pustakam. So these words, they are all neuter genders. So most of the words which applies, which obeys these rules, but few will be exceptions. That those exceptions we will see later. So is that clear?
Okay.
So if you see Deshaha, Deshaha, it ends with Aha. So it must be masculine. So Saha Deshaha, the question could be Kaha Deshaha. And Vahanam, it ends with Im. It is a neuter. So you have to say Tat Vahanam and Kim Vahanam. So these are basic rule which applies for almost everything. But there are few exceptions, like example, Mata, Sa Mata, and Pita. Pita is a masculine word. But though it ends with long A, but still it is a masculine word. Saha Pita. So you cannot say Sa Pita. It must be Saha Pita and Kaha Pita. So those words we will not be touching now. So those words we'll learn later. So for now, it's very simplest words we'll be seeing. So with this, I'm just moving to the next one. The next one is the same thing, he, she, and this. So the previous was that, and this page was this. So you might probably know the difference, this and that. This we generally use it to specify the objects nearer to you, and that is used to specify or point out the objects which is little far away from you. But in English we have this difference only for this word, this and that, and for he and she we will not say. He and she is a single word. Like this he and that he we will not say, or this she and that she we will not say. But in Sanskrit we have that differentiation, like he, she, this means this he, this she, this object. So basically you can say the word for he, for the nearer person, you can use eshaha. So the remaining, the rules will remain the same, like saha, ramaha, eshaha, ganeshaha. Okay, saha, ramaha, eshaha, ganeshaha. He is Rama, that person is Rama, and this person is Ganesha. And saha, lakshmanaha, eshaha, arjunaha. He is Lakshmana, and this person is Arjuna. So hope you are getting the meaning and difference between saha and eshaha. And similarly, for sa is to point out the person who is far away from you, and to point out the person nearer to you is esha. Esha Sita, sa Sita, esha Mala. She is Sita, and this person is Mala. So that person is Sita and this person is Mala. So she, sa Sita, esha Mala. So only difference is you will be adding a before the word. So saha, eshaha, sa, esha. And similarly for tat it will be etat. Tat is to point out a far object, and etat to point to a nearer object. It's similar to that and this. Etat will be this and tat will be that. So you can say etat pustakam, etat phalam, etat pushpam, etat vastram, etat dwaram. And this, and the same will apply for all non-living things as we seen in saha. Like eshaha vrikshaha, eshaha margaha, eshaha devalayaha. So basically you are pointing out the objects which are just nearer to you. You just point out and you can say. But saha and sa and tat will be a little far away from you. So in that case you can use saha, sa, tat, and if it is very closer to you, you can use eshaha, esha, etat. And you can say esha vatika, esha kupi, esha nadi, and etat mitram. Okay. And the questions for this one remains the same. There is no difference in the question. The question will be kaha, ka, and kim. Etat pushpam, etat kim, you can just point out a nearer object and you can ask etat kim, and etat pushpam, kim pushpam, so etat pushpam. So kim, kaha, ka, these three words will not change according to the gender, only, not gender, basically distance. So eshaha, esha, etat. So these are the new three words we are learning as part of this page. Okay, so let's go ahead. The summary will be the masculine and feminine and neuter. And for distant objects, we use saha, sa, tat. And the nearer object, we use eshaha, esha, etat. And the question words will be kaha, ka, kim. Okay, so no questions from here, I hope so. So let me go ahead. So let's as part of this session, let's try to learn new words as much as possible. Because now itself we came across very new, we learned few new words like Sanganakam, Dwaram, and Lekhani, Dooradarshanam, Dooravani. So like that, every when you start talking, when you start framing words, then you will be in the demand of words. So then that is the time you can learn the words. But if you don't try framing sentences, then it will be very difficult to learn new words. So I request everyone to frame yourself own sentences. So that will really help in improving your vocabulary. So let's take few examples, few vocabulary words for today. So I hope everyone is able to see the window in my screen. The first one is the flight, that is called Vimanam. It is Vimanam. And the second one, the cup or the glass, which is called as Chashakaha. It is Chashakaha for cup or the glass. And the bag is called as Siyutaha. It is Siyutaha. And the comb is called as Kankatam. It is Kankatam. And two-wheeler, the cycle, is called as Dvichakrika. It is Dvichakrika. Dvi is two and Chakrika is one, which is with two wheels. And the spoon is called as Chamasaha. It is Chamasaha. And the key is called in as Kunjika. It is Kunjika. And the weighing scale is called as Tula. Tula. And the scissor is called as Kartari. It is Kartari. And the telephone is called as Dooravani. It is Dooravani. And pen is called as Lekhani. It is Lekhani. So these are a few words for today. So if you see, observe these words, we can find the gender for these words. We'll try to find the gender. So Vimanam is ending with Im, so it is a neuter. So it is Tat Vimanam. Chashakaha ends with Aha, so it is a Saha Chashakaha. Siyutaha ends with Aha, that means a Visa, A and Visarga, so it is Saha Siyutaha. Kankatam ends with Im, so it is a neuter, so Tat Kankatam. Dvichakrika, so it ends with long letter, it is Sa Dvichakrika. Chamasaha ends with Aha, is a masculine word, Saha Chamasaha. Kunchika, it again long vowel, so it is Sa Kunchika. Tula, Sa Tula, because it is long vowel at the end. Kartari, so it ends with E, so it is a long letter, so Sa Kartari. And Dooravani, Sa Dooravani. Lekhani, Sa Lekhani. I hope you understood the gender, how to identify the genders. So maybe let me repeat these words again. Vimanam, Chashakaha, Siyutaha, Kankatam, Dvichakrika, Chamasaha, Kunchika, Tula, Kartari, Dooravani, Lekhani. So Now let's get started with how do we use the dictionary. Suppose if you want to frame your own sentences, how you can frame your own sentences. So let's, as I said before, you can use the online dictionary, SpokenSanskrit.de. So here you can actually give English word which will translate to Sanskrit and give you back. Or you can give a Sanskrit word which will give the meaning for that word. So let me try a simpler thing like house. So it gives most, there are many words which will mean the same meaning like house. So here if you see vasatihi and alayaha, alaya and griha. So these are all the griha we'll take because it's a very well known word. So if you check griha, there is a, it also says which gender it is here. You can see the gender here. It's mentioned as N. N means neuter, M means masculine, and F means feminine. So griha, when you are using it, it becomes griham. You cannot say griha, it will be griham because in all neuter words will end with im. You can actually use it as griham. And similarly, if it is a masculine, you can use it as alayaha. And if it is a feminine, you can use it as vasatihi. So maybe let me take another example. Okay, let's take Sanskrit to English. So vimanam, you can actually search, but actually all the suffixes will remove it while searching. We will not actually search with vimanam, so it will be just vimana. So when you search with vimana, you can find the meaning of that. And similarly, chashakaha, you can find cup or glass. So this is how you can try cup. It might give chashaka. So this dictionary helps you for beginners, like to just to know the words. So probably you can try framing your own words like saha, sa, tat, and using the items nearby you. You can water bottle or mobile or laptop, door, house, temple. So any of such words, you can try to look up into the Sanskrit dictionary and you can try start framing sentences yourself. So that's all about dictionary use. Okay, let me just go to the next part. So we already know how to make a simple questions like Saha Ramaha. We can make questions like Kaha Ramaha or Saha Kaha. So this is the two possible questions which we can make from Saha Ramaha. So there is another question also we can make, that is a yes or no type of questions like he is Rama. You can ask, is he Rama? And he is Krishna. Is he Krishna? So you are asking, you are confirming whether he is really Krishna, is really a Rama. So it is basically, the answer for these questions will be generally yes or no. So I can show you an example. Saha Ramaha. You can ask Saha Ramaha va. So va is suffixed, or va is a word which makes the statement as a question. You give the answer and you just confirm it back. Like Saha Ramaha va. Similarly, Saha Balakaha. He is young boy. And you can make question, is he young boy? Saha Balakaha va. And Saha Gayakaha. He is the singer. You can ask, is he the singer? Saha Gayakaha va. And similarly, Sa Sita. She is Sita. You can ask, is she Sita? So Sa Sita va. And similarly, Sa Vaidya, Vaidya, doctor. sa vaidya. Is she doctor? So sa vaidyava. And bhavataha nama dineshaha. Your name is Dinesh. Is your name Dinesh? That is a question. So bhavataha nama dineshaha va. So basically the actual statement doesn't change. The actual statement looks very complete, like saha balakaha, he is bai, saha gayakaha, he is singer, sa sita, she is sita. But only the additional thing is va is added to just confirm whether that is true or wrong. So one more example, esha samskrita kakshya, this is Sanskrit class. So question would be, is this Sanskrit class? So esha samskrita kakshya va. The statement remains same, only va is getting added. So this is how you can ask any yes or no type of questions. If you want to confirm anything, you can ask, you can make the sentence and you can add a va at the end. Okay, so what could be the answers for these? Like saha rama hava, is he rama? You are asking, is he rama? So what could be the answer for this? The answer could be yes, he is rama, or no, he is not rama. Either of these two could be answers. So you can say aam saha ramaha, yes he is rama. So saha ramaha va, is he rama? Aam saha ramaha, he is rama. And similarly the negative will be na, na saha ramaha na, no he is not rama. Okay, so and similarly you can give another answer like na saha krishnaha, saha ramaha va, is he rama? Na saha krishnaha, no he is krishna. Is he rama? No he is krishna. So only these three kinds of answers you can expect, like aam saha ramaha, na saha ramaha na, na saha krishnaha. So here important thing to observe is three new words. Va is added at the end of the sentence to make the statement as a question, and aam is for the positive answer and na is for the negative answer. If you want to decline something, you can just say na, and if you want to accept, if you want to say yes, that is aam. And one more example, sa parvati va, is she Parvati? Aam sa Parvati, yes she is Parvati. Na sa Saraswati, no she is Saraswati. I hope you are getting. And similarly for this one, tat pustakam va, is that book? Answer could be aam tat pustakam, na tat patram, no it is paper, patram is paper. Tat pustakam va, aam tat pustakam, na tat patram. So anybody have any questions till here before we get started with another one? Or can you make any yes or no questions using va and answer yourself with aam or na? Can anybody try? What are things that we learned is he, she, that is saha, sa, that, and he, she, this, eshaha, esha, etat, and who and what, kaha, ka, kim. And the few vocabulary items we have seen, like vimanam, chashakaha, and those items. And we tried to making yes or no kind of questions like saha ramaha, saha ramaha va, saha krishnaha va. So these kind of questions we tried to make. And we have seen how to use dictionary, and you can use the dictionary. So along with this, I'll be showing a book. I will be sharing a link to a book. So which has some exercises for whatever we are studying right now.
Thank you everyone for attending this session. See you all in the next session. Thank you.